whoa, what's that smell? I mean, it smells like a fish market in here.
Oh, hey, Mr. Bubba. I'm not really sure what you're talking about.
You don't smell that very fishy smell? Oh, that's what it is.
That's what is?
Wow. I wish we had smell-o-vision so you could smell what I smell.
I don't smell anything, Mr. Bubba. What do you smell?
I guess you've become so used to the smell of fish, you can't smell your tuna.
Oh, yeah, that. Yeah, I guess I am used to it. I'm sorry. Let me just put this away.
Yeah.
Here. That is pretty strong.
I guess so. Why are you dressed like Gorton's fisherman? You don't fish.
Well, I am actually Gorton's fisherman. See, Gorton's fisherman? Because my name is Kevin Gorton, you see? But once I saw what we were learning about this month, it made me think of fishing.
I bet it will be exciting. Let's see, you talked to us about birds in August, and it was the weather last month and fishing this month.
Yeah, you got it, Mr. Bubba. So today I wanted to teach everybody about what I was eating.
You're going to teach us about what you were eating?
Yeah, what? No, not what I was actually eating. I mean, I was eating tuna and I want to teach you about tuna, so maybe. But I wanted to teach you this month about fish, starting with the tuna. This isn't a tuna, this is a trout, but take a look at these pictures. Out of the 15 types of tuna, the bluefish tuna is the largest. They can live up to 40 years and dive as deep as 3,000 feet. They are made for speed, built like torpedoes. They have retractable fins and their eyes are set close to their body.
Wow, I didn't know that. That's pretty cool. All this talk about fish and water makes me think of a fun song that our worship team can lead us in.
Right. Good idea, Mr. Bubba. Hey, let's all get up on our feet and get ready to sing with our worship team. Let's go.
Bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, bubbling up, up to the surface.
You know, those tuna you were teaching us about are pretty smelly, okay? Two, when you're eating it, that reminds me of the big question.
The big question? I don't see how the big question, what do you mean? How does that have to do with being smelly?
No, but remember how you couldn't smell the tuna? Because you were so used to it.
Oh, yeah, but I still don't see how that, I don't get it.
Well, that's how people are sometimes.
That is so rude, Mr. Bubba. I mean, we're on camera too, talking about smelling.
No, not with the smell, but with sin. People get so used to doing things wrong that sometimes they don't even realize it's wrong.
Okay, I can see that. That's a pretty good illustration, Mr. Bubba. But I still don't see how it reminds you of our big question.
Well, let's see what the big question is this month. Drum roll, please. Why should we obey God?
Well, and the answer is, drum roll, please. We should obey God because He made us, He loves us, and His plans are good.
Yes, very good, Mr. Kevin. Thank you. Right. Many times we forget that when we continue to sin and get so used to it that we think it's normal.
Yeah. You are on a roll today, Mr. Bubba. That leads us perfectly to our Bible story video.
Right.
Our story also has a really big fish in it, just like I taught about earlier. See if you can spot the big fish in the story and how God used it.
God told the prophet Jonah, "Go to the great city of Nineveh. Tell them to stop doing evil things." The people of Nineveh were enemies of God's people. Jonah did not want to go to Nineveh, so he got on a boat heading the other way. God sent a terrible storm, and the sailors were afraid. They cast lots to figure out who caused this trouble. The lot fell on Jonah. The sailors asked Jonah, "Who are you? What are you doing here?" Jonah replied, "I worship the one true God who made everything." What had Jonah done to make God angry? The sailors did not know what to do, so Jonah told them to throw him into the sea to calm the storm. When they did, the storm stopped. From that moment on, the sailors worshiped the one true God. God sent a big fish to swallow Jonah. And Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and three nights. Jonah prayed and thanked God for sending the fish to save him. Then the fish vomited Jonah onto dry land. God told Jonah, "Go to Nineveh and preach my message." So Jonah went. He walked into the city shouting God's message. In 40 days, Nineveh would be destroyed. The people turned from their evil ways. Even the king repented. God decided not to destroy Nineveh. "I knew it," Jonah said. "You are a gracious God. You show mercy to people. You are slow to anger and you are loving. I knew you would decide not to destroy Nineveh. I am so mad." "Is it right for you to be angry?" God asked. Jonah left Nineveh and made a shelter where he could still see the city and what God would do. God taught Jonah a lesson. He provided a plant to shade Jonah from the sun. Jonah was glad to have the plant. But the next day, God sent a worm. The worm attacked the plant and the plant died. Then God sent a dry east wind. Jonah was so hot, he almost fainted. "I want to die," Jonah said. God asked Jonah, "Is it right for you to be angry about the plant?" "Yes," Jonah said. "It is right. I'm so angry, I could die." God said, "You cared about the plant, but you did not take care of it or make it grow. It only lasted one day. Nineveh is a big city with thousands of people. I created them and care about them. Aren't they in the animals in the city? more important than a plant?
I saw the big fish, did you? Do you think that it was a bluefin tuna, Mr. Kevin?
No, bluefin tunas aren't that big. They can't swallow a whole person, like in the story. You know, it might have been a whale of some kind, or who knows, maybe a special fish that God created just for this job.
Good.
Just like he created Jonah for a special job.
Oh yeah, to go to Nineveh. It sounded like that they had become so used to their sin, they didn't realize it was wrong.
Right. You know, every story in the Bible points us to Jesus. How do you think the story of Jonah and Nineveh points us to Jesus?
God called Jonah to go to his enemies and call them to turn away from their sin. But Jonah refused. Instead, he ran away. Later, God sent Jesus to his enemies to call us to repentance. Jesus willingly obeyed. Jesus died on the cross to rescue us from sin.
That last video reminds me a lot of our memory verse this month, Mr. Kevin.
Yeah, you're right. Hey, how about you and I say it together, Mr. Bubba, before the kids join us? Okay? On 3, 2, 1. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some understand delay, but is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but all to come to repentance. 2 Peter 3:9.
Hey, Mr. Kevin, let's explain that verse a little bit. The first part says that the Lord does not delay his promises. That means that he is quick and keeping his promises. They may not happen when we want them, but they will happen in his time.
Yeah, and then it says that he does not want anyone to perish. That means that he doesn't want anyone, you, me, Mr. Bubba, anybody in the whole world, to die without believing in him.
Yes. And then it says that all would come to repentance. That means that he wants everyone to turn from doing wrong to doing right instead.
Yeah. Hey, how about all of you now out there say the verse again with Mr. Bubba and I on 3, 2, 1. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some understand delay, but is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but all to come to repentance. 2 Peter 3:9.
Great job. Now, let's join our worship team to sing a song to help us remember the memory verse.
you, Mr. Bubba. What you got there?
Oh, some things in my bag that I brought up here for you to look at, sir.
Okay. There's your
Xbox controller, car. Yeah.
Those are pretty nice things, I guess. But why did you bring your collection up to the clubhouse? You know?
Yeah. I wanted you to see them, okay? Well, I wanted you to sort them for me.
Sort them? Sort? I mean, there's just five things. You can't sort that?
Well, I know. But I want you to sort them in the order of importance. What you think is most important to least important.
Okay. Well, I'm going to start with this guy right here. This is number one, and then probably number two. I think probably number three. I'm going to put this coin, number four, and this book.
Wow. Thanks, Mr. Kevin. Why did you choose that order?
Well, the car, that's awesome. I'd love to have a car like that. That's important. And Xbox, those are just cool. You play games. iPad is like information at your fingertips. Coins, you know, they're worth some money. And the book, well, that's kind of all ratty and I don't know, it's just kind of old looking.
So to you, these things have different importance.
Yeah.
Maybe based on how you could use them, how they look. But as we learned today from our Bible story, God doesn't sort people by most important or unimportant.
Oh, wow. You are right, Mr. Bubba. To God, every one of us is just as important as everyone else.
That's right, Mr. Kevin. God loves all of us all the time with all His love.
Wow. That is a lot of alls, Mr. Bubba.
That is.
God wants each of us to turn from our sin and turn to Him and love Him. He wants all of us to be saved through His Son, Jesus. Jesus died for the sins of all the world.
That's right, Mr. Kevin. Before we go today, let's bow our heads and close our eyes to worship God through prayer. Dear God, Jonah first chose to disobey God and not help rescue his enemies in Nineveh. Thank you, Jesus, for obeying God and coming to rescue us even when we were your enemies. Help us to show our love for you by obeying you too. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for joining us this week.
Yeah. Hey, we hope you'll come back next week. Bye.